more decorum, if you don't mind. It's a very, very important evening. It was just a few weeks ago that we brought you the finals of Mr. Puniverse. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, we have a fantastic festival of flesh for you. The ladies are beginning to swoon. Yes, tonight, it's a special evening. It's the finals of Mr. Poseur 1984. 12 top finalists are going to be paraded in front of you in just a moment or two. Thank you for all the mail that we've had on the subject. I've even received a Poseur's memo pad here from Cheryl MacDonald, who's at Ravensley Road in London. Absolutely invaluable, this. There's a little checklist of things you have to do. Check charisma before you go out. Blow dry your chest hairs. This is my favourite. Give yourself a love bite. I'll pass that on to Mike Reed. Now, also, you might remember we had a lot of interest in the tap dancing rhino and the juggling hamster. You remember all that. And last week we were able to bring you a juggling hamster, but I had to show you this. It's just a little bit late. It comes from Emma Hodge, who's age 12, and she lives near Marlborough in Wiltshire. And look, she made me a juggling hamster. Well, thank you to Adrian and Nick of Broke Productions, who brought us the juggling hamster last week. They've gone one better this week because they've given us the posing hamster. Look. You're so vain. And here he is arriving in his Golf GTI. Now, wouldn't you think a hamster would drive a Volvo? All right, never mind. There he is at the wheel of his car. Despite the rather awkward, damp conditions, he's obviously well in control of that. He opens the dormouse. Now, where's he going? Ah! I think he's on his way down the pub to meet the girls. Yes, he's got his regular cocktail there. What a super posing hamster. I think our 12 finalists are going to go some to beat this guy. He's cool, he's smooth, the women love him. Look at that, the girls flocking to. Just chat to him and wish him well, his little medallion. Hey, that is one cool hamster. Oh! Ah, now his girlfriend arrives. What are they going to do? Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for making that, chaps. That really is good. I've got a marvellous hit squad for you tonight. We go international. We are going all the way to Spain with the hit squad. Also in the Golden Egg Awards, we have a policeman who has a spot of trouble on point duty, and we've got a marvellous clip from an Australian game show, and it all goes completely wrong. Frankie is going to go to Hollywood, and Smitty... popular move. They've only been back in the country for 24 hours or so, and they've come here. See him in a moment. Smitty is at the Skyline Hotel somewhere. Where are you? Where? Smitty?
Is this Dunker?
It's Blashford Smith.
It's Blasher Smith. Good heavens, what have I found here? What's that?
Codpiece.
Oh, my codpiece is here. Yes, you're quite right. Welcome to... The reason I was down there, actually, was I found this at the bottom of the pool, Noel.
What is it?
It's a copy of today's Daily Mirror. I don't know whether you can see that. It says, The Worst Noel on
yes.
it. It's a picture of you.
Dressed as a fairy, yes. I'm glad we can't see it, actually.
Yeah, it's gone a bit blurred under the water, but it was at the bottom of the pool anyway. This is the Skyline Hotel at Heathrow, and I've got a microphone here.
They seem to have a damp problem in the rooms.
I beg your pardon?
They've got a damp problem in the rooms. Never mind,
just,
carry on.
Yes, I will carry on here. The Skyline at Heathrow, this is the pool and the bar, which has got the stools, you can see, that actually go into the pool. So some very strange nights they have here. We have our two whirly wheelers of the week here. This man is Mike Fian. Hi, Mike.
Good evening.
Hello.
Hello.
He's the PE teacher.
Hello, what's he got there?
Good evening. It's a card from the pupils at my school for my form.
Oh, that's nice. Where's the school?
Malvern Hall in Solihull.
Great, jolly good. Hopefully they're all rooting for you at the moment.
I hope so.
Now, Mike's going to be doing gymnastics later on this evening. You'll see that in just a while, in fact. Some gymnastics around the edge of the pool, so you need to get ready for that. And this is Joe Hamilton.
Hi, Mike.
What are you laughing at?
Well, look, I mean, she looks like she'd come from the hairdressers and taken the dryer with her.
Thank you, Noel. I really appreciate that. Great.
Now, Jo, as you know, lives on cows in the Isle of Wight, Noel. And she's...
surely she has a little vegetable with it.
All right, I'll feed them, you laugh. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So, cows in the Isle of Wight, she can swim, but she's been training this week to do some synchro swimming, haven't you?
Oh, I have, yeah. That was hard.
Well, you almost gave up on Tuesday, didn't
you? I did, yeah. I had a dreadful day. I really wanted to go home.
But you got it all together.
Oh, yeah, we're brilliant.
Yeah, we stuffed some more money into her dress and she was all right. So she'll be doing the synchro swimming later on, but right now it's time to join the Royal Corps of Transport Gymnastic Display Team with their newly recruited member. This is Mike Fian.
Cool. Now, what are they doing, Mike?
Well, these manoeuvres are... actually, what they're doing is auditioning for Superman 4 here. But it's that or it's Peter Pan pantomime. I'm not too certain. Mike Fian is the one there with a light top on who's just gone out of shot. Now, he is a PE instructor, but he hasn't done anything quite like this before. He's been training for a couple of days with the Royal Corps of Transport's team. And he's done jolly well indeed. Now, as we're so close to Heathrow...
fell over! fell over!
As we're so close to Heathrow, we've got a feeling that this might actually be the new Virgin Airlines walk-on service.
Oh. What are they doing
now? Right, now this is individual displays. That means that each man makes a complete idiot of himself.
Yeah.
In a most unusual way, twisting and turning in the air and all sorts of things.
That's a good one, like that one.
How about this one, like that?
Yeah, that's nice, like the backward flip at the end. What's he going to do?
Oh, that's the Stacey Keach.
Woo! What's a Stacey Keach?
It's so you can jump out. At any moment now, we should have Mike coming through to land astride that man. Here he is.
What's this? Oh, a Joan Collins.
Right, now they're going to go and line up, ready for the finale to this act, and this will feature several individual members of the team. This is Corporal Onion.
Corporal Onion.
Spring Onion.
Oh, very good.
And, yes, that's Corporal Maxwell, who's from Prague.
Oh, I know, the check bounced. Yes, got it.
Bouncing check.
Yeah, got it.
Now, this really is the final part of the act. The man who will lead off this part of the act is another corporal in the team, Corporal Pickett.
Yeah?
The flying Pickett.
Oh, very good. Look like they're getting liquidated.
This is the manoeuvre that's recommended. You should be going on holiday to the continent next year, and you find all the cross-channel ferries are booked up.
This is what all the little kids do in the pool, isn't it? Oh, that was a good accident, like that one.
That's not what all the little kids do in the pool, but we won't go into that.
Yeah.
Now, Mike should be coming up for his finale at any moment. Here it comes. No.
Oh, that was good. They didn't like him, did they? The guys holding the bench.
No.
Here he comes.
Friends. This is Mike.
We'll go back for more hilarious stupidity at the Skyline Hotel in just a little while. My musical guests this week have hardly been out of the news recently. According to which newspaper you read, they're either the most fantastic band there's ever been, or they're really awkward. I was chatting to them earlier, and they said they had a great time in America. No, they didn't fall out with Gene Kelly. The record is doing remarkably well over there. I'm delighted that they have chosen to come on the show literally within 24 hours of coming back in the country, because it's the first time they've presented this number live. It is, of course, number one. I'll get on with it now. Frankie Goes to Hollywood.
Feels like fire. I'm so in love with you. Dreams are like angels. They keep at bay, at bay. Love is the light, scaring darkness away, yeah. I'm so in love with you, birds and soul. Make love your goal.
Television's most coveted and prestigious awards. Presented by Noel Edmonds. The Golden Egg Awards.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Well, we start off this week with our Golden Egg Awards with a very, very difficult decision for the Academy. They didn't know whether to give this prestigious trophy to Bob Ledwich of BBC Norwich
or indeed to pass it on to a horse called Bandit. As you will now see, the horse won by a neck. In fact, a very long neck.
If the Red Wings Horse Sanctuary does reach its target of £116,000, then it'll be able to raise a lot more. Sorry, start again. If the Red Wings Horse Sanctuary does reach its target of £116,000, it'll be able to raise a lot more horses. Oh, I couldn't finish it, sorry. Right, this is the one. If the Red Wings Horse Sanctuary doesn't... Hang on, sorry. Right, here we go again. This is the one. If the Red Wings Horse Sanctuary does reach its target of £116,000, then it'll be able to save a lot more horses like Bandit here from the Knacker's Yard.
Oh, well, let me hear you. Of course, the horse was a Mustang, and it must hang its head on some of the... Now, a wonderful clip from Australian television. This is a game show which has a version of the Whirly Wheel. Well, it's not really a version of the Whirly Wheel. This is more of a Wally Wheel.
Radius? Yes, it is. $125. Off you go again. The aim is to amass as much money in your bank as possible. Top money spinner becomes our champ.
Now we come to the prestigious Egg on Face Award. And first of all, we have a clip from Diverse Productions, who are doing a programme for Channel 4. The programme is called Kabul Autumn. It's obviously about Afghanistan. It features a policeman who quite clearly believes that he is a major contribution to road safety. He later sued the council for damages. Two chaps have sent us a video, Ian Garwood and Richard Beach. They're in the fourth year at Armwood School in New Milton, and as a project, they were told to build their own hovercraft. Well, one of the teachers, Mr. Markland, agreed to video the first test flight of their own hovercraft. I leave it to you to make your mind up now as to whether or not this is an accident or a deliberate attempt to run the teacher down. The epitome of the Golden Egg Awards. This is really what it is all about. Yet another American reporter who has quite a big problem. I must say, I don't know what he's up to, but possibly you can work out exactly what he was attempting to do.
Conditions in the Middle West are driving up grain prices, catching local poultry farmers in a tight...
Well, that's it. The end of the Academy's nominations for this week. Next week, it's the final show in the series, and we'll present the very best of the Golden Egg Awards. However, on Christmas Day, as you might have read in the national press this week, I'm doing a special edition of this programme, 90 minutes live on Christmas Day. We start at 11 o'clock and we go through to 12:30. The whole show will be coming live from the top of the telecom tower in London. We have a whole load of different things, so the whole country can join in with phone-ins. A lot of excitement. I'll tell you more about it next week. But we've also got a rather special helicopter. It's got a camera on board,
and it's one of the most sophisticated cameras in the world. If you would like us to look in on your Christmas Day celebrations, and you're vaguely near the centre of London, because we're only on the air for 90 minutes, would you please let us know as soon as possible? You might well think, no, I don't want him anything to do with my Christmas. But on the other hand, you might think it'd be rather nice to be seen enjoying your Christmas live on BBC One. Anyway, that's a thought for the future. More about that special show on next week's show. But now, the big moment. The moment that all the ladies here have been waiting for, and some of the chaps have waited for, hoping to pick up the odd tip. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Poseur, 1984.
Ladies and gentlemen, the BBC is proud to present the finals of our nationwide search to find the man who will not be at all surprised to learn that he is Mr. Poseur, 1984.
Yes, this is a big one. Yes, that exciting moment where 12 finalists are going to do battle, strut across the stage and outpose each other to walk off with the coveted title of Mr. Poseur 1984. There is only one gentleman we could have as our judge this evening. It has to be Mr. Medallion Man himself, David Copperfield.
Stand there all night.
Thank you, thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm here.
Pardon?
Hi. Oh, only one glass, never mind. Nice to meet you, good evening.
Well, nice to meet you, sir.
Would you like to sit down a moment, Dave? Clearly, what we need is an indication of what we are looking for this evening. I mean, what makes a good poser, in your opinion?
Well, in my opinion, I would say, as long as they just come a little bit below par on me, they would be absolutely stupendous. And, they have to be lovable and available and, most important of all, terrific.
I can't get over the teeth. They're brilliant. The colour of those teeth. Do you have a favourite chat-up line?
Oh, yeah. Well, at this time of year, I would probably say something like, hi there, chick, how would you like me for Christmas? Cool, you know what I mean? Cool.
Are you of the opinion that posers are, in fact, conscious that they do it?
What do you mean, man?
No, I don't mean conscious when they do it. I mean, are they conscious of this... No, obviously not.
No, I don't know what you mean. I'm sorry. No.
Where do you go to get your metalwork?
Oh, there. Well, every guy's got to have the gear, you know. I mean, I got to wear all the clothes and that. And, you mean these chains and things?
Hmm.
Well, I go to Manet Ironmongers.
Don't get metal fatigue.
Hey, was that a joke?
Is there an ideal age for posing?
Well, I would say the ideal age for a cool guy to start this line of work would be, something on my age, about 22, you know what I mean?
It's fine.
Cool.
Well, it's a tough evening for you this evening, David, because it's hot competition.
So I hear.
Yep. Here they come. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our 12 finalists. And the first of our carefully coiffured contestants is Mark Andrews. Mark from Telford, Shropshire. He has brown eyes, he's 6'4", he's a blue coat, and he loves giving service with a smile.
Hi, my name's Mark Andrews, and I'm gonna live till I die. I'm gonna play for the sky. Ain't gonna miss a thing, I'm gonna have my fling. I'm gonna live, live, live till I die.
Thank you very much. Number two is Lawrence Fader, representing Digby's nightclub in Leeds. Lawrence is 6'2", with blonde hair and red eyes. He's a sales consultant, and his hobbies are lying on his sunbed and polishing his medallion.
Hi, my name's Lorenzo. My hobbies are ladies, exquisite food, and champagne. And, of course, myself. It must be a great pleasure for Noel, Spike, and David to be able to meet me in person tonight. Because I'm not here under any false pretenses. I'm here because I'm the natural, original poser.
Number three is Nick Krotker from Plymouth. He's 5'10½" tall with brown hair and blue eyes. Nick is a courier for a holiday company, and his hobbies are starring in all his clients' holiday videos and consumer testing suntan creams.
Thanks a lot, Noel. Actually, that is right, but a lot of people won't realise that my real name is hidden beneath not just a hairy chest, which is non-existent tonight, but in fact, these are the lights which keep my real name away. It's not really Nicky Schiff, as I'm known to be mates with one certain holiday company which has been in the newspapers, but it is, of course, Mr. Sexy.
Tristan Ward has swaggered here from Stapleton in Leicestershire. Tristan is 5 feet 6 inches tall with blonde hair and green eyes. He's a finance broker and advises ladies how best to invest their money. On him.
Voila. Well, my name's Tristan, but you can call me Tristan by name. Well, if I do win this, it won't be any real shock. I sort of get myself prepared for these things anyway. Sorry? Oh, if you think my aftershave's a little overpowering, don't worry. It's just my personality you can smell.
Number 5 is Shaz Qureshi from London. Shaz says, after a hectic night's dancing and drinking, he still manages to look $1 million, all green and crinkly.
Hi, my name's Shaz, and really I haven't got a clue what I'm doing here. Because you see, to be a poser, it means you're pretending to be something you ain't. But I've got everything. I mean, why am I here? The only thing I haven't got is one ambition left in my life, is that I want Bananarama to ring me up and for me to say no. Thank you.
Number 6 is Lee Garrity from Leeds. Lee is 6'1", with his own hair and slate grey eyes. He says all the girls in Leeds think he's magic. At least they're always asking him to disappear.
Hi, girls. My name's Lee, but you can call me Clint. If you'd all follow the queue down here, I'll get round to you all in a minute. I'm sure you all want to know all about me. I'm 6'1", rippling muscles everywhere. I'm probably counting my own blonde streaks. My ambitions really now are just to own a helicopter like Noel so I can get around and please more ladies.
Number 7 is Horace Yearwood Grisette, who was recently voted Mr. Super Cool 1984. His hobbies are checking the gossip columns to make sure they've spelt his name correctly and staying out of the wind.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Horace Yearwood Grisette. It's not a name, it is a title. I'm a hairdresser and subsequently involved with women. However, I'm not accustomed to chatting ladies up, but if you wish, I can always get you a reference from my previous girlfriends.
Number 8 is Derek Clancy from Devon. Derek is 5'11", with black hair on his head and grey hair on his chest. He has brown eyes and his hobbies are looking at photos of himself and combing his chest.
Hi, girls. As you all know, I'm Derek. I've had a problem lately, but it is being sorted out. I kept jamming up my phone at home, so I've had to go ex-directory because of telecom. Just a few things about me. My vital statistics are I have a villa in Bermuda, I earn 42 grand a year, and I've got a helicopter, but it's being serviced right now. Just for those of you who haven't met me, you'll get your chance. Ciao.
Thank you, Derek. Number 9 is Mark McCormick from Northamptonshire. Mark part owns the Bull's Head Arthingworth. As you can see, he's brought his part with him, and his hobbies are improving his chat-up lines.
Good evening, admirers, and welcome to my show. May I say how nice it is for you to see me here tonight. My name is Mark McCormick, but my entourage of chic chicks call me the Doberman. Why, you ask? Well, it's the poser who packs the powerful pinch. Thank you, my darling.
Thank you, Mark. Number 10 is John Browning from Wiltshire. John is 6 feet tall. He has dark brown eyes. He's a driver with the Ministry of Defence, and his hobbies are perfecting his smile and looking sensational.
Hi out there, all my fans. I'm John. I bet you're glad you didn't watch the A-Team tonight. My ambition is to become a male model or a centrefold. So all you agencies out there, the highest bidder gets me. Thank you.
Number 11 is Kevin Lowe from Maidstone. Kevin is 6 feet 1 inch tall with brown eyes. He's an insurance clerk and his hobbies are being seen in all the right places and looking sincere.
Hi girls, my name's Kevin. They call me the face in Maidstone. You can see why. Aren't you glad you paid your TV licence?
Number 12 is Neil Macy. Neil is 6 feet 1 inch tall with blue eyes, and the Sotheby's expert recently valued his jewellery as worth between £1 and £2.
Hi, I'm Neil Edward Macy, steady Eddie to my friends. I'm a personal friend of Joanna Lumley's, and I'm an expert at excavating naval fluff. What more can I say? Obviously left the best till last. I'd like to thank in advance my producer, the manager, and my mother.
Thank you, Neil.
12 finalists for Mr. Poseur 1984.
Well, as you've seen, they've had an opportunity to express themselves in the finest possible way. I don't know whether I should be with them or try to run away from them. But of course, we can't take their word for it, can we? We have to put them to some sort of test, and that happened just a few days ago. We put them through some initiative tests last week.
Lawrence is first onto the floor with that just something I threw on look. Unfortunately, the weight of his medallions is proving too much, and his anti-gravity boots don't seem to be working. And here's Mark Andrews with the designer look. Mr. Andrews' wardrobe is courtesy of Butlin's, and his hair is by McAlpine. Nick, however, prefers man at CNA and is preparing to move in for the kill. Note the carefully turned up collar to conceal any evidence that he is in fact an accountant. This fine figure of a man is Shanks. His nightmare is to be abandoned in a hall of mirrors with the lights out. Here he is, enjoying his own company. Tristan Ward. He describes himself as a self-made man. Unfortunately, he seems to have lost the instructions. This is Lee Geraghty. Lee is on his own because his partner has asked him to move on. She said people were beginning to feel sorry for her. Here's Horace showing off his specialist skills, the courting rights of the lesser spotted teenager.
Horace, you can call me any time.
Oh, my name's Paula. You can call me Mrs. Smith.
Usual phrase. Your champagne, sir. Oh,
thank you.
Horace shows us he's really cool. I mean, really cool. Of course, a true poseur knows when he's had enough and leaves before making a fool of himself. And now, let's see how the contestants fare at chatting up Marty Kane.
Where's my card?
Lorenzo, as in Arabia.
Yeah, super stud, yeah. Obviously.
For good vibrations.
That's right. Well, no, I do give good vibrations.
Doesn't that interfere with your hearing aid?
Clint Thrust.
Clint Thrust. That throws off the tone nicely.
Hi.
Are you old enough to smoke?
Excuse me, is this your gold credit card or mine?
As I was walking sometime yesterday.
Gonna come home with me tonight. You're gonna have to take those shoes off.
Why, do they lady in nylon sheets?
No, they put dents in the roof of the Porsche.
Pass away the time.
If you want, I could get you a reference from my previous girlfriend.
Do you like the perfume? It's a new brand. It really, really knocks the girls out. Oh, desirable, desirable.
It's one of us has to be.
Unbelievable.
I'd like to show you my photo collection on my ceiling in the bedroom.
Do you live in a Lego village?
Horlicks for the lady, please. Ice and a slice.
I think it's time. I left you.
Are we going home now?
Is that the royal we, or have you got a tapeworm? If you wish, I shall never know your we've not been to Scouts.
But you were waiting there.
Time.
You put your shilling in your mouth, can you see the Swanee River? Listen, would you go and feed my meter for me?
Yeah, sure.
It's parked in Basingstoke.
I've never been to Basingstoke.
I'm sure the studio audience would like to join me in hoping that Marty Kane gets well very soon. She's in intensive care, getting over the shock of meeting all these gentlemen. But anyway, I have David Copperfield's deliberations here, and we are down to a final six. So could the gentlemen please step forward as I call out their names? Firstly, through to the final, Shaz. Derek, Neil, Lawrence, Lee, and John. Pause for a moment, allowing them to enjoy themselves and hate the other five.